We are here at the SPH Auditorium for the auditions of the My Paper Executive Look 2011. And who are we looking for? Executives who can shine beyond their office walls. The 100 contestants who turned up at the auditions were shortlisted from more than 530 people who registered. The goal? To find 16 finalists, 8 male and 8 female, among the shortlisted candidates. For the auditions, each contestant had to give a self-introduction, a minute and a half long, to the judges in front of other candidates. For the first time in this contest, which is in its fourth year, a Caucasian executive made it through to this stage of the contest. This also marks the first time doctors signed up to compete. Out of the three shortlisted doctors, Dr. Tiffany Young was the first to be auditioned for the day.
Hi everyone, my name is Tiffany Young. I'm a fully registered doctor in family practice and medical aesthetics right now. I also am completing my graduate diploma in family medicine in a few months, and that's one step to becoming a family med specialist.
We asked the 2010 Mrs. Singapore Universe why she joined the My Paper Executive Look contest right after her husband pointed it out to her.
Well, it's not so much for my practice, but it's more to show myself for who I am. Yeah. So, cosmetics doctor is my job, but I'm definitely more than that.
Also through to the shortlisted round of auditions was the first Caucasian spotted in the contest, 33-year-old site manager Scott Brown.
I actually noticed I was the only Caucasian guy in there, which made me feel a little bit more nervous than what I already was. So.
Scott had a life story that not only impressed, but tugged at the heartstrings of the judges.
At the age of 14, my parents split up, and it was left us really difficult at that moment in time. And when I got to the age of 15, I was living on the streets. Life wasn't going very well for me. My school was affected, and it affected me until the age of 16. Until one day I woke up and I decided to join the British Armed Forces to get away from the life that I was heading into, which wasn't a very good one.
But it's not just a compelling life story that the judges are looking for. Contest organizer and chief judge Tommy Lin tells us what they were looking for.
A person who is really driven and who communicate really well. Someone who everyone wants to employ. You know, this contest is not about, it's not just about how good you look. We need people to have that sense, of identity, who really believe in his cause as well. And obviously he has to be somebody who represents the very urban workforce and very dynamic workforce of Singapore.
So how did the judges feel this year's candidates fared?
Well, I think they are really strong and very exciting. I'm so inspired by them. It's like, and this year we got a really good international mix, and they bring with them a lot of experiences, and they bring with them a great diversity in terms of perspective as well. It reflects well on my paper. Why it says that my paper has reached out to a wider group of readers and people who are high flyers.
Well, they all have different stories to tell, but who will make it through to the finals? To take a sneak peek at some of the more interesting female executives that we met, stay tuned to the next clip.